Well, good evening, friends. Thank you so much for taking the time to join us in prayer this evening. I'm so glad that you are here. If we haven't had a chance to meet yet, my name is Hope Ledbetter-Bach, and I serve as the pastor of community life here. As we get settled into our time of prayer tonight, if you haven't yet had a chance to, I'm going to invite you to just take a minute and prepare your space in such a way that it invites you into worship. We recognize that we can worship from anywhere, but that there also is something about preparing a space for worship that I think helps call us and prepare us to worship God in a way in this time that is set apart from kind of our normal everyday walking around moments. So I'd invite you to grab a candle, maybe a cross, perhaps even a journal or your Bible for this time of prayer tonight. As you gather these things, I'll explain a little bit about kind of what our time will look like tonight. We're going to have a little bit of time of centering silence at the beginning. I hope that this silence will help prepare our hearts for worship. We also will have time of prayer, times of lament, times of hope. We will join together in song, and we will close with a blessing. As we get started, though, I'm going to invite you, as I said, into this time of silence. So feel free to use this time to continue to set up if you want to go grab your candle or something like that as we get started. If you are ready to go, I might invite you to use this time to kind of clear your mind and to center yourself tonight. If you're like me, there's a lot stirring in you right now, and perhaps even over the last couple days. So if your mind is like mine, it's constantly racing and trying to process what is and what might will be. So give yourself some grace tonight as you quiet your mind, acknowledging whatever comes up, but also trusting that God will be with you to walk in the midst of it, whatever is to come. Friends, fear not. Our God says, I am with you. For those of you tonight who are hurting or feeling afraid or sick, or those who are feeling worn thin, tonight's one of those nights that, gosh, I just wish we could be together. It's a night that I feel like we need to be reminded of our shared humanity. This is a time particularly that I think I also need to be reminded of the Imago Dei, the image of God that resides in each and every one of us. Therefore, that reminds me and calls me to look after each and every person as a beloved child of God. I hope that tonight, in our time of prayer, that it is a small reminder that no matter what it is that you are going through or what it is that you are processing, that you are not alone, but that our God is with you. Friends, let us enter into a time of silence as we prepare to pray together. Friends, let us pray. Holy Spirit, dwell with us tonight. Draw near to us, O God. Weep with us, suffer with us. Do not leave us alone in our grief, but let us find a refuge in you, our God. Amen. Friends, I want to begin with Psalm 130. It reads, out of the depths, I cry to you, O Lord. Lord, hear my voice. Let your ears be attentive to the voice of my supplications. If you, O Lord, should mark iniquities, Lord, who could stand? But there is forgiveness with you, so that you may be revered. I wait for the Lord. My soul waits, and in God's word, I hope my soul waits for the Lord more than those who watch for the morning, more than those who watch for the morning. O Israel, hope in the Lord, for with the Lord there is steadfast love, and with our God is great power to redeem. It is God who will redeem Israel from all its iniquities. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. Well, friends, for our evening prayer tonight, I want to offer us the ancient practice of lament and hope. If you're not familiar with it, lament is a practice that kind of helps us move through any pain of our current reality. It allows us to honestly name before God what we are feeling so that we can clear a way to honestly name before our God our hopes and our praises. In my own life, lament has helped me to be able to clear a way towards praise of God more honestly because it clears a way to truly name what it is that I honestly feel before God so that I can praise honestly and fully and wholly. I find that if I tried to offer songs of praise when I'm actually feeling really anxious or heartbroken, I could really only kind of offer half-hearted praises to God. But if I first name before God how I am really feeling, all of my questions, my sorrows, my heartbreak, then after offering all of these burdens to God, I can actually praise God more fully and more authentically. Friends, lament clears a way for praise. Lament clears a way towards hope. As we read Psalms of Lament found all throughout the Psalms, there's always an interesting kind of turn in them. The psalmist will name all kinds of laments and questions that they have, and then all of the sudden, though literally nothing has changed, there's this move towards hope at the end of many psalms. The psalmist tells us that they expect to be delivered from their present circumstance. They even anticipate praising God even more fully. Friends, honestly naming before God our fears, our hesitations, our questions, and our doubts, and even our laments, it clears a way for us to praise, to remember who God is and who God has always been, even in the midst of our doubts. Friends, I'm going to invite us into a time of lament and a time of hope. I will offer up prayers kind of on behalf of the gathered community, but I'd invite you also to either write down or name before God your own prayers of lament, your own prayers of hope. Let us pray together. God, all is not as it should be. We've come to the end of our rope, and the only thing we can do is cry out before you, our God. So much feels out of control right now. Where are you? Come to us quick. We are afraid, unsure of what the future holds. We are aware of our divisiveness now more than ever. We've felt it in our bodies, we've known it, and we've seen it at times. But we cannot ignore the fact that no matter what happens in the coming days and weeks, no matter what results come in, we are clearly a people that are divided. We are weary, worn thin. We are tired of being tired. How long, O Lord? Save us, God, and quiet our fears. Hold us in this time of unease. Be our sure footing when we do not know where to stand. Beckon us back to you. God, we demand that you would draw near to us as we draw near to you. Make yourself known. We boldly ask that you would show up today, right here, right now. God, we come to you with our fear in all its complexities, realizing that the feeling we feel is because we sense real threat. whether it be to ourselves or to our neighbors. So we ask that you would comfort us in the complexities of our fear. Be a place of rest for the anxious. Teach us to fear that which leads to wisdom, and the love that drives out fear. Teach us the fear that leads to wisdom, and the love that drives out fear. Shape us into students of your love, ever learning to care for our communities more deeply. Do not waste these disorienting days, but teach us to better love our neighbors. Teach us again to hear the cry of the needy. Beckon us to care for the sick and the vulnerable. Even when we feel uncertain and disoriented, we boldly ask that you would be our shepherd and our guide. You are our comfort, the one that catches us when we find ourselves at the end of our rope. You've been waiting all along, ready for us to reach out. So we praise you with all that we are, and right now as we find a home again in your arms. When we find ourselves feeling like there is no stability, you, O God, are our rock. You are our God. You made all that is and all that will be, so we have nothing to fear. You are always bringing order out of chaos, and today that promise is no different than it was yesterday, or the day before, or a week ago, or 8 months ago. You are still God. We praise you because you hear us when we cry, and when we ask where you are before the words are even off our tongues, we know that you have already drawn near to us, to our suffering and to our pain, and to the unimaginable suffering and pain of our brothers and sisters. In the midst of our pain, you are right here. You've been here all along. You gather us in like a mother hen hovering over her chicks. You offer us comfort, peace, and hope. We cannot wait to praise you, our hope, our Redeemer. We cannot help but sing of your goodness. You heal the sick, you comfort the hurting, you bring peace to those who are afraid, and you draw near to those who suffer. Thank you. Thank you. We offer all of our praise to you, the one who holds the world and all that is in it. You are our God, and we will praise you forever and ever. Amen. Friends, I'd invite you to continue in prayer, continue offering your own praises, your own hopes, and even your own laments to our God. As we continue in a posture of prayer through our next song called Reason to Sing.
When the pieces seem to shattered, to gather off the floor, and all that seems to matter is I don't feel you anymore. No, I don't feel you anymore. I need a reason to sing. I need a reason to I need to know that you're still holding the whole world in your hands. And I need a reason to sing. When I'm overcome by fear and I hate everything, if this waiting lasts forever, I'm afraid I might let go. I'm afraid I might let go. I need a reason to sing. I need a reason to sing. I need to know that you're still
friends. I want to leave you with this blessing from Jan Richardson. It is in her book, Circle of Grace. This is called A Blessing for the Waiting. I actually do not know what will change between now when I'm recording this and so much is still unknown and when this is posted. But I recognize that when this waiting ends, there's always another waiting that will begin. If you've been with us recently, you might know that we are in the midst of a sermon series about blessings. And in my own life, blessings continually call me back to hope. Blessings call me back to rest in God, even in the midst of times that feel uncertain or even in the midst of times that feel more filled with pain. I think that blessings are words of hope and words of comfort that we need right now in these days. So I'd invite you to receive this blessing in a posture of receiving. So you can open your hands, open your palms to receive this blessing benediction. This is called A Blessing for Waiting. Who wait for the night to end, bless them. Who wait for the night to begin, bless them. Who wait in the hospital room, who wait in the cell, who wait in prayer, bless them. Who wait for news, who wait for the phone call, who wait for a word, who wait for a job, a house, a child, bless them. Who wait for the one who will come home, who wait for the one who will not come home, bless them. Who wait with fear, who wait with joy, who wait with peace, who wait with rage, who wait for the end, who wait for the beginning, who wait alone, who wait together, bless them. Who wait without knowing what they are waiting for or why, bless them. Who wait when they should not wait, who wait when they should be in motion, who wait when they need to rise, who wait when they need to set out, bless them. Who wait for the end of waiting, who wait for the fullness of time, who wait emptied and open and ready, who wait for you, bless them. Amen. Friends, may you go in the peace of Christ. May the peace of Christ be with you. Amen.